Hey, it's Justin from Transistor, and today I'm going to show you a new private podcasting feature we've been working on. So I'm going to start by creating a brand new podcast, and I'm going to call this the Transistor Employee Handbook, because I'm going to use it to onboard new employees as they join the company. I'll just add a quick description of what the show is about, choose my artwork, choose the language, and I'm just going to create the podcast now. All right. The show has been created, and now I can create my first episode. Welcome to Transistor. Earlier today, I recorded this introductory episode. Hello, and welcome to the that will introduce the show. So I'm going to upload that now. Perfect. Once I'm done that, I'll just click create an episode, and that is now published. Now that we have a published episode in the private podcast feed, we can start to add subscribers. Now we could do this individually just by adding their email here, like that. Once you add a private subscriber like this, they'll receive an email like this that will give them instructions on how to add that private feed, their individualized feed, in the app of their choice. So you can see, this is my individual subscriber's feed here, and I could open this inside of iTunes. So now I'm subscribed to the Transistor Employee Handbook, and if I wanted to, I can play the episode. I open this email on my phone, I'll get different instructions based on the mobile apps that, in my case, an iPhone would have. So I can open this in Overcast, for example. And there it is right there, the Transistor Employee Handbook. You can see it has a lock icon to indicate that this is a private feed. And if I wanted to, I could start to play the show right here. Back in our subscribers tab, we can see that the employee was notified via email about the podcast on October 1st. And if I refresh, you'll see that they have now activated, meaning that they have subscribed and downloaded at least one episode. Now in the future, this employee might leave the organization. All I have to do is go back into here and remove the subscriber. And now they will no longer have access to that private podcast. So if I go back and test this by opening up that original email, the subscriber will get a message like this, that they no longer have access to the private podcast. And now that that subscriber's been deleted, if we were going to add a second episode like this, even if they have the first episode downloaded, they won't receive any new episodes. Now, you don't have to add your subscribers one at a time. You can also add them in bulk by clicking this link and uploading a CSV file. When you import a CSV, you'll be given the chance to review everyone you want to add. Remember, as soon as you add people, they'll receive that welcome email that looks like this. I'm going to click Add Subscribers. And now it says they've been notified on October 1st, and I'm just waiting for them to activate. These private podcast links work on Android as well. As you can see, I've received the email here. I'm going to click on that. And you can see here, I have a list of podcast apps that work on Android, and it opens that link up in the podcast app.
Hey, this is Justin, just testing out the new private.
So regardless of what platform your employees are on, they'll still be able to subscribe to your private podcast feed. Not all podcast players will allow you to add a private podcast feed. I have a list of the apps that support private feeds on our website. In addition to adding subscribers and giving each person a private feed, you might also want to embed these episodes in a private area of your website. To do that, you go to the Episodes tab, click on this embed link. You can choose from the light or dark theme, copy that, and then head into your website editing area. This is WordPress here. And in my case, I'm going to paste that in to an HTML block. So this is how my WordPress website would password protect that page. I'm just going to enter my password. And once I've done that, I can access the embedded podcast episode. One thing you'll notice about the embedded player is that we've removed the ability to download or share these episodes. All you can do is hit play. We're also planning on having an analytics area for these private podcast feeds. This is still early. This isn't exactly how it's going to look, but you can generally see how many subscribers you have, how many have activated, and then how many subscribers, what percentage of subscribers have listened to each episode. You'll also be able to see which apps subscribers are using to access your private podcast. We're really excited to see how people use these new enhanced private podcast feeds. For example, authors might want to have an audiobook that only readers can access. Conferences might want to have a private podcast feed only for attendees, where they publish all of the talks from the conference after everyone's gone home. And of course, employers who want to connect with their employees. For more information on this feature, just contact us at Transistor. You can email us at help@transistor.fm.